Former Canadian High Commissioner to Trinidad and Tobago, Gerard Latulippe, says the process currently employed by the judiciary to discipline judges is inadequate. He was speaking at the opening of the 2017-2018 law term at the Holy Trinity Cathedral in Port of Spain. Ian Wason has more.
President of the Republic, Anthony Comuna, Prime Minister Dr. Keith Rowley, and some members of Parliament were among the congregation at the Holy Trinity Cathedral in Port of Spain. After saying the lack of accountability was the root of impunity, former Canadian High Commissioner to this country, Gerard Latulippe, said the Chief Justice lacked remedies to keep judges accountable for their actions.
In Canada, judicial councils are responsible for the good behavior of judges. They are composed mainly of judges, lawyers, but also of members of the public. They adopt and apply a code of ethics for judges. The code contains, among other things, an obligation to judges to abide by the directives of the Chief Justice. Members of the public can file a complaint against a judge.
He said the system in this country must be reset and changed for improvements to be made. He added, unreasonable delay denies justice to the accused, and every accused person has a right to justice. He cited an example of a 2008 case in Canada.
For taking part in a drug deal in British Columbia, but was not convicted until February 2013. His lawyer appealed the case, arguing that the delay of 49 months was unreasonable. The majority of judges of the Supreme Court decided that all parties were operating within a culture of complacency in Canada.
He said in Trinidad and Tobago, the judiciary was being retarded for many reasons, but these must be overcome to improve accountability.
However, the system is still disturbed by flaws, such as a culture of adjournment, judge delaying ruling, slow turnover of forensic analysis, poor evidence gathering, staffing shortage. There is a culture of sluggishness that has settled into the system that needs to be changed through improved accountability.
After the interfaith service, the parade then proceeded to the Hall of Justice for the ceremonial opening. Ian Wason, CNews.